What's going on, everyone? Tech Me Out here, and in front of me, I have the world's first 5G PC, and it's made by Lenovo. So big thank you to Lenovo for sponsoring this video. But I'm super excited because you know we've been talking about 5G up here a lot lately, and mostly 5G on mobile devices and things like that. But now the mobility is to our PC. And I love the fact that it is because it allows me to be untethered. So I don't have to be, you know, restricted by wires or Wi-Fi. I can conduct my business or just handle my regular tasks and just using my PC here. So I'm out and about right now. We're just gonna test the overall experience you might expect if you decide to pick one up for yourself. So when it comes to the Lenovo Flex 5G, you have a 14-inch screen. You also have two USB-C ports on the side. You have a power button, headphone jack, and also a switch for quick access to airplane mode. And then right there dead in the center, you have your SIM card tray. So it's super light. It's actually about maybe 2.9 pounds, so it makes it perfect to just throw in the bag and go. You also have a two-in-one design. Take this, bend it all the way back, and use it either in tablet mode like this, or I could actually use this as a stand. So I can go like so, like that. There we are. So real convenient, and I love being able to like look at a video like this. And the touch screen just makes it a lot easier as well when I wanna, you know, just quickly access things. I don't have to rely on the keyboard over here. And then I can just collapse it up when I'm done and go. Now, in terms of what you get in the box with this, you actually get, of course, the PC, the power adapter, the USB-C cable, and your pamphlets that have the user information and all that good stuff. So real simple packaging. So inside of the Lenovo Flex 5G is backed by the power of a 2.84 gigahertz Qualcomm Snapdragon 8cx 5G. So that means it then has the power, speed, and efficiency to get things done on the fly. So with it having 5G, it does actually seamlessly switch between the 4G LTE service and the 5G service, which basically allows me to kind of have like a portable office. So I'm currently out right now, and I love the fact that when I do go out, I don't have to worry about trying to find somewhere to connect to Wi-Fi. I don't even have to worry about the battery life on this thing because it gets up to like 24 hours in a single charge. So I can handle my intensive tasks and even my less intensive tasks without even having to worry about being near a power outlet. And the benefit though in having like the 5G service built into this is that you have that security, because when you connect to public Wi-Fi networks, you do have to kind of be mindful of what you're doing on it, which isn't something that you don't have to really worry about when you're using, you know, the 5G or 4G service on your PC. Now, I know I've been the type in the past that has always felt like I can just, you know, connect to my mobile hotspot and I'll be good. But I will say, when you're trying to get things done, you don't want any extra steps in between what you're trying to do and getting it done. So in having that service already built in here, it just speeds things up for me and it just makes things more fluid. So with it being powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 8cx 5G, along with an integrated X55 modem, the Flex 5G actually provides lightning fast download speeds of up to 2 gigabits per second, which means that's gonna make this 10 times more faster than a 4G connection, which is another advantage because 9 times out of 10, your mobile hotspot speeds are not going to match or even beat that in which you would get using 5G. Now, when it comes to typing up here, I found the keyboard for me has a really nice travel because it's very shallow and it has a soft touch and it's not very clicky. I just love the idea of always being connected because as soon as I open this up, it's ready to go. And on top of that, speaking of, if you're concerned about security, you have a couple of different ways that you can actually gain access into the computer. So one way is for it to open up and then scan your face and boom, I'm in. That's my favorite way, which is using Windows Hello because it's just the most seamless way to gain access to my computer. But if you don't like the whole face scan thing, you can always use the fingerprint reader instead, or you can do the traditional method and just type in your password. And the other thing that I just can't get enough of is the two-in-one design, because I love that, you know, I can basically configure my setup to be what I want it to be when I need it to be. So when I'm doing more intensive tasks, I tend to keep it like this, but when I'm chilling on the couch or something and I'm just kind of lounging around and I don't really need the keyboard, I love that I can just switch it over and go into tablet mode. Or my other personal favorite is using the tint mode so that I can view my content like this, which is really great, especially when I'm watching a video. Which, might I add, does look really good up here because it has a 1080p display, so the images are very sharp. In the top center, there's a 720p camera, so I've been able to take my conference calls just about anywhere if I need to. To me, it just further resonates a theme that I've been noticing with this setup. With things just kind of always being ready to go, you have phenomenal battery life, you have built-in cellular connection using 5G or 4G, and you have that 2-in-1 design to offer the versatility. So it just checks a lot of boxes for me, especially when it comes to a machine that I want to take with me on the go to get my work done. But if you are interested in this, I'm gonna have a link for you down below that not only will allow you to check this out, but also save quite a bit of money on it as well, as Verizon is currently offering a $400 off promotion on it. But I'm curious to know your thoughts. How do you feel about the Lenovo Flex 5G? Overall, I'm enjoying it, so I hope you do too. But if you enjoyed this video, I'm gonna link some more content on screen right now that you can check out. But until the next one, y'all, as always, thanks for taking the time out to let me tech you out.